Shukrastvamagnistvam vayustvam suryastvam chandramastvam brahma bhurbhuvasvaro gnadim purumuchaya varnadim stadanantaram manaswara parataraha ardhe indulasitam tarena ruddham edattava manusvarupam Gakar Purva Rupam Akaro Madhyam Rupam Anuswarashchantya Rupam Binduho Uttara Rupam Nadasandhanam Sahumhita Sandhi Siksha Ganesha Vidya Ganaka Rushihi Nicharat Gaditri Chandaha Shri Maha Ganapatirte Vata Om Gam Ganapataye Namah. Already we have entered Bhadrapada Masa. As soon as we enter that divine, very appeasing, people-friendly form of Sri Ganesha, it comes to our eye. Everywhere it is, Ganesha, Gauri, Ganesha, Gauri. Tomorrow we are going to celebrate Gauri Utsava. Before the sun comes to the limelight to bless us, we offer our worship to his mother so that Gauri Ganesha, that is how 2 days celebration it is projected in this part of great nation. In this great nation, there are many modes of worships. Even the deity may be one, but mode of worship will be different. In Maharashtra, their mode of worship is different. In Karnataka also, in southern part of Karnataka, their mode of worship differs from that of northern Karnataka. That much beauty of variety, it is attached to every celebration. But once we think about Ganesha, 2 words become very important keywords. One is Buddhi, another one is Siddhi. In our Purana, Ganesha Purana, these two are projected as divine consorts of Lord Ganesha. So Lord Ganesha will be always accompanied by Buddhi and Siddhi. These 2 words are yogic words. Siddhi, Siddhi, these words are repeatedly uttered by all great masters of yoga. Siddhi means achievement. Ultimate achievement is called Siddhi or accomplishment. That is the real translation of that word, Siddhi. We human beings, we are for accomplishment, ultimate accomplishment, fulfillments of our wants and wishes. It is very important. Hum humare, hum apne, jivan ke raaste pe, Siddhi prapta karna chahte hain. प्रसिद्धि की कामना ज्यादा है आजकल, किंतु प्रसिद्धि यानी फेम एंड नेम आता है जाता है, किंतु सिद्धि हम अपनाएं तो शाश्वत के लिए वो संभल बनकर रहता है. दैट विल बी रियल फूड स्टफ फॉर होल लाइफ जर्नी. सो दैट सिद्धि The very important master key word when we go for celebration of Lara Ganesha on Chaturthi Bhadrapada Shukla. That is very much natural. When we go for Siddhi and Prasiddhi, ultimate accomplishment or fame and name, we must have Buddhi. That Buddhi, it is very much disturbed now due to our food system, ahara, vihara, vyavahara, thoughts, emotions, all are disturbed. That is why Buddhi, it is corrupt. When Buddhi becomes corrupt, very difficult to understand the reality. That is what our representative Partha, Partha, Kunti's third son, Arjuna, he also became victim to this problem. He was a very buddhiman, very intelligent fellow, very great math accomplishment. From very student life he was so bright, great adventurer, named for adventures, even in his student life. Vyasa says, even from very boyhood, how he was very brilliant student. How could he catch hold of Drupada Maharaja just to bring him, that great emperor of Drupada Rajya, and brought him and tied him to the cot where Drona used to sit. That is how he could repay Guru Dakshina to his great master, man of archery, Dronacharya. That is how from very boyhood he was so much named, famous for adventure. Even that man, Arjuna, he succumbed to Vishada. Vishada. Vishada means depression. Buddhi becomes a disturbed. Buddhi and Manas, they go hand in hand. When you are emotionally disturbed, your Buddhi never works properly. Here the same problem, Arjuna became victim to it. Arjuna ke man mein uljhan, uljhan ubhre the. Iske parinam swarup buddhi mein ashuddhata aa gayi. Buddhi ashuddh hui. Is karan se uske man mein vishad aaya. Vishad yane depression. Dukha aa gaya. So, when we go for study of the whole Bhagavad Gita, we must study the first chapter, which is called Vishada Yoga, Arjuna's Vishada Yoga. What is that Vishada? Vishada is a special type of syndrome. So-called psychologists, you know, they call some words they use, syndrome, mania, phobia. These are all psychological terminologies. Sometimes Vishada and these words our young boys and girls, they don't know. But these words they know, mania, phobia, syndrome. Psychological terminologies they are. What is this? When you develop some sort of too much attachment, too much detachment, ati tiraskara and ati puraskara, both are dangerous. Ati puraskara means you are so much sold out to that. So much sold out that every time you think about that, that occupies your mind. This is some type of problem. This is called phobia. Or mania also. Cinema. Phobia. In phobia there will be fear working. In mania, every time moha will be working. However, because of fear or because of passion, when you are sold out or lost somewhere, you become victim to all these psychological abnormalities. Syndrome is that one which you take it so seriously and stretch it to that much length that you cannot be there without that. So these type of mental abnormalities are there. Even man like Arjuna becomes to victim to these syndromes, mania, phobia. So these three combined, it is called Vishada. That's all. So that we must go for mind reading technique. Purely, it is purely scientifically structured, you know, Bhagavad Gita. Sometimes we unnecessarily talk scientific. But in our tradition, we never go for so much fractions, so much dissections. It is too much now. Every time going for dissections. That is why this is psychology, this is methodology. Like that, there are some words in our dictionaries. However, dictionaries are there for that purpose only. You have to use them. You cannot leave them unused. That is why you have to use so many words. That is why we have given many, many names for different segments of knowledge. But for our rishis, knowledge is one very much comprehensive holistic structure. There you can just make some departments and apartments for your convenience of understanding, that's all. Otherwise, it is yoga, it is adhyatma, it is called Vedanta, it is traditional knowledge, it is jnanam, it is vijnanam. Many words are there. But now, for the convenience of understanding, we go for different names. Okay. But calling our traditional knowledge, this is scientific and this is unscientific, it is very unscientific. Because our rishis, without experimentation, they have not uttered even a single word. Because they were so friendly to their own inbuilt lab, that is their own life, their own panchakosha. This panchakoshatmaka body, that was the main lab for them. So that in this lab, everything is there, nothing is left. In annamaya, pranamaya, manumaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya structure of this body, nothing is left. Everything it is rested here. Yadeva brahmane tadeva pindane. What is there in this wonderful universe, same thing structured in our pindanda, means body. So there also you see prithivi, aptejo, vayu, akasha, sattva guna, rajoguna, tamoguna, 5+3. Same thing 5+3 here. Just understand. Yadeva brahmane tadeva pindane. Whatever 5+3 it is there in this whole cosmic structure, that is the same thing it is in your body. So that is to be understood properly. So in this lab, we have to study. So we have that third layer, Manomaya Kosha. There if you have problem, its effect will be there on all sheets. If mind is depressed, if your mind is succumbs to this type of vishada, syndrome, phobia, mania, immediately its effect will be on pranamaya kosha, so that your breathing will be abnormal. Its effect will be there on your annamaya kosha, there will be diseases, illness after illness. And its effect will be there on vijnanamaya kosha, so that your understanding power comes down and diminishes. Your creativity will be lost, your understanding capacity will be less, that is how your vijnanamaya kosha also gets disturbed. That's all. That's why Vishada is very, very dangerous. But Vishada comes here to Arjuna, why? It is because he got a small consideration. Only Kula Dharma and Jati Dharma he considered very highest. It is not that Jati Dharma and Kula Dharma are bad, very good. Because in our own family tradition, we inherit many fine arts, many skills that we have to maintain. In the same time, some boys, by their very birth, they get some skills developed. Very inborn, they are called inborn talents, inborn singing talents, inborn painting talents. Some children, by very birth, they start playing with mridanga, with all ragas, with all tadas. Even such inborn talents also we can see. That is why this Kula Dharma and Jati Dharma, they are very great boons for us. But beyond these two dharma, there is one very important dharma that is called Swadharma. That Krishna highlights later on. Swadharme nidharam shreyaha paradharmo bhayava. That part we take up later on. Now, this day, let us start with the understanding of the first chapter where the main yoga, it is called Vishada Yoga. Now, before going to celebrate Krishna Vinayaka Chaturthi, let us have this Buddhi Shuddhi. Buddhi Shuddhi and Vishada cannot go hand in hand. Vishada we have to remove. More and more we keep this Vishada away, we can develop Buddhi and Siddhi. Oh.